Hello and welcome back, and in this lesson we will understand what exactly is electromotive force or the EMF and how it helps us to generate current. So let us put a capacitor in a circuit, and when we do so, what we see is charge flowing from the positively charged plate to the negatively charged plate. But then as the positive charge flows from this plate to this, it neutralizes the negative plate, and then the flow of the charge stops as both plates reach the same potential or become neutral. So you see, the current did flow, but for a short while. But to get real flow of current in a circuit, we need to figure out a way of pumping the charges continuously. And this can happen only if we can find a device that can do so, and we put that in the circuit. Well, such devices are called EMF devices, and one such EMF device is a battery. So, a battery provides a force to the charge carriers to enable them to keep moving in the circuit and therefore generate current. And this force comes from the chemical energy of the battery. So, let's see what really happens when we introduce such a device in a circuit. Well, to explain the idea, I would first like you to imagine yourself to be in a ski resort where you are at the top of a hill. And since you have the gravitational potential energy, you can slide down the hill, but while doing so, you lose the potential energy when you reach the bottom of the hill. Then, if you wish to continue skiing, you have to be carried up to the top of the hill by some external force. Well, this could be a lift that takes you up to the top of the hill against the force of gravity and therefore does work in carrying you up. Then once you are on the top of the hill, you again have the gravitational potential energy to slide down. Now, let us use this analogy to explain what is happening here inside the battery. So, a charge at this point where the potential is VA can move through the circuit because it is at a high potential, quite like when you are at the top of the hill and slide down. It moves through the circuit and reaches a point of lower potential VB. Now, this charge cannot automatically move from this place of lower potential to a place of higher potential on its own. And you can see the reason is that the direction of the electric field is downwards from the positive plate to the negative plate, and therefore a positive charge has no chance of moving towards a positive terminal against this field. Quite like you cannot move to the top of the hill on your own against the force of gravity. So eventually what will happen is that all the positive charge would move from point A to point B and neutralize the negative charge, and therefore the original potential difference VAB that existed will become zero, and both points would come to the same potential. So what can we do if we want the current to continue flowing? Well, we need a force that will take this positive charge from this point to this and in the process raise the potential of the charge, quite like the force of the lift that overcomes the gravitational force to take you to the top of the hill. And this force here is provided by the chemical force of the battery. So let us go ahead and denote this force as Fn. So you see, this force Fn is carrying the positive charge from here to here, thus creating a positive potential here and a negative here. In a way, the force is helping maintain the potential difference Va minus Vb that would have otherwise become zero. So you see, Fn, that is a non-electrostatic force, just about overcomes the electric force Fe and carries the charge up to the positive terminal. And so we say Fn is equal to Fe. Now, since force Fn causes displacement in the same direction as itself, we can say positive work is done, but then we also see that force Fe is acting on the same charge in a direction opposite to the displacement and hence does negative work. So the total work done is zero, and if the net work done is zero, the kinetic energy of the charge does not increase. But you can see the potential energy has increased since it has moved from a place of low potential to a place of high potential. It is quite like you moving from a place of low gravitational potential to a place of higher potential without changing your kinetic energy, but still increasing your potential energy. So this source of non-electrostatic force continuously maintains this potential difference VA minus VB between the terminals to allow the charge to keep moving around in the circuit and therefore helps generate the current. Now, let us understand the same thing through a few simple formulas. Well, we say that the work done by the chemical force of the cell in moving a unit charge from B to A is denoted by this symbol, or kind of a curly E is what it looks like. It therefore has units of joules per coulomb or volt, in a way quite like potential. And this symbol is often called the electromotive force. But it is not really a force as we just saw, but traditionally it has been termed that way. So when we say that a battery has an EMF of 1.5 volts, what we mean is that the battery does 1.5 joules of work to move a unit charge inside the battery from one terminal to the other, or more accurately, from a place of lower potential to higher potential. So if we moved a positive charge Q from terminal B to A, the work done by this chemical force would therefore be Wn is equal to Q times the electromotive force. Now, since the potential difference between point A and B is VA minus VB, or let's call it VAB, the potential of the charge Q goes up by Q times VAB. And since we just showed earlier that there is no change in kinetic energy of the charge, the work done on the charge by the non-electrostatic force must equal the change in potential, or Q times the electromotive force is equal to Q times VAB, or the electromotive force is equal to VAB. Now, let us put this battery in an actual circuit where there is a resistance R. We know that the potential difference between the terminals A and B will create an electric field in the wire that will make current flow from A to B. Let us say the value of this current is I, then the potential difference between the ends of the resistor can be given as VAB is equal to IR. Then if we combine this equation with this, what we get is electromotive force is equal to VAB is equal to IR. Well, we could interpret this equation as the rise in potential of a unit charge as the charge moves from B to A is equal to the potential drop VAB across a resistor as the same charge moves through the wire from A to B. Now, we say that this is an ideal source of EMF because there is no drop in potential inside the source. But then, just like there is no frictionless plane, in reality, every source of EMF, in this case a battery, also has an internal resistance that causes a drop in potential. And if this resistance is denoted by a symbol R, then as current I moves through this resistance, the drop in potential would be I times R. So we can say that VAB is equal to electromotive force minus IR. So this is called the terminal voltage with internal resistance. Look at it another way. The increase in potential energy of unit charge VAB as a charge moves from B to A inside the source is now less than the work done by the electromotive force, since some potential energy is lost in overcoming the internal resistance. So If you are given a battery that reads an EMF of 1.5 volts, you can say that the terminal voltage VAB will also be 1.5 volts as long as there is no current flowing through it. That is, I is equal to 0. But the moment current starts flowing, the terminal voltage reduces by an amount IR, where R is the internal resistance of the battery. Now, let me close this lesson by summarizing the key points, since this topic is a little tricky and needs a bit of repeat watching to understand better. So, point number one is that an EMF device like battery does work to maintain potential difference between its output terminals. Two, an ideal EMF device is one that has no internal resistance, in which case the EMF equals the terminal potential difference. Three, in reality, every EMF device has internal resistance that causes reduction in terminal voltage. And four, the terminal voltage will be the same as the EMF if there is no current or I is zero. So if you like the video, do give it a thumbs up, share it with someone, or just post a comment. And yes, don't forget to ring the bell below to get notifications when I publish a new video.